Yo me lang san bonani lo chani Here's what happened on Mubango 20 May 2021. James said he was not going anywhere until they get married, even if it means staying in a bench for the whole night. The worker at Home Affairs came back to the office and said he will spend the few minutes before attending his child's graduation. James and Imane were so excited they got married finally. Shuri and Mubango were at the clinic. The nurse told Shuri to go to bed and it's time now. Shuri was nervous and asked more time. The nurse said there was no time. It's either they do it now or never. She has more patients waiting for her. Mubango said they are no longer doing it. Shuri said she wants to do it. Mubango said he will take care of the baby. They left the clinic. Rendani, Mahangwane and Sharon were talking about Marang and they blamed her for being a monster. Rendani said she feels bad. James and Iman have been through a lot. She wants to throw them a surprise reception and the Dugathole is the perfect location. Mahangwane said she will bake them a cake and decorate the venue. Sharon said Buchilo will be a DJ. Gugu had a meeting with Bubbles, Horsey and Idumini. She said she appreciates what they have done. Horsey said, what is the price? Because he won. Gogo said she only wanted them to work together as a team. There's no price and told them that she has an announcement to make. Idumeleng is leaving and it's her last day today. Bubbles was so sad and asked why she didn't tell them. She said she didn't think they care. Horsey said, of course they care. They will miss her. And Bubbles said, who will she gossip with now that she's leaving? Gogo said, that's good. She'll focus on her job now. She then left the boardroom. Horsey said later today, after James and Imani's celebration, they have to go to party and all drinks are on him. James made a breakfast for Imani and wanted to serve her in bed. Imani came to the kitchen. James said she spoiled everything. He was going to serve her in bed. Imani said they have to go to work. James apologized to Imani and said he should have known that Marang was going to trick him. Imani forgave him. James received a phone call from Rendani. She told him that she has organized a photo shoot for them at Dugathole. James thanked her and said he forgot about photos. They are coming. Susan and Azwindini were worried about Mubango. Susan asked him where he was last night. He said he knows he doesn't love him and he doesn't want to buy him a laptop. And his mother was right. He is not a good person at all. Azwindini said that's not the way to speak to elders. Mubango left them while Azwindini was still talking. Susan asked how he found out. Azwindini said maybe he might have heard them talking. Rendani was preparing at Dugathole and the place looked so amazing. Rendani thanked her mom and Sharon for preparing at such short notice. Denda and Paul showed up. Rendani asked who invited them. Gugu saw them and called Denda and said it's James's reception. James would be happy to see them. And then they stayed for the celebration. James and Imani arrived and they couldn't believe it. And James said he thought it was a photo shoot. Rendani said no, it's their reception. They thanked Rendani and celebrated. Mubango met up with his girlfriend. Shuru said she still wants to do an abortion. Her family will disown her and she will have to drop out at school. Mubango begged her not to abort the baby. James and Imani were celebrating and everything was cool right up until Hulisani showed up and shouted his uncle and said he doesn't want to help him. Denda said he's humiliating him in public. Rendani said Hulisani must leave. Hulisani told her to shut up. She can't even cook. He regrets marrying her. Their marriage was the worst time of his life. Rendani said he will not address her like that. Hulisani asked who's getting married and said it will end in tears. They should just drop it. Mpo said they have to talk somewhere private with Hulisani. They left. Rendani said the celebration continues. Buchilo played the music. Mubango came back and Susan said she didn't mean to hurt him and she doesn't hate him. He said he doesn't care about a fake apology. Susan left. Azwindini asked if he bought the laptop. He said it was out of stock. Azwindini told him that he will speak to Horsey. He's the IT specialist. He said he mustn't worry about that. He will borrow from his friend. Dendan and Hulisani were at each other's throat. Mpo intervened. Hulisani said he wants the money. He robbed his life. Denda said he's not getting a cent. He pulled a gun and pointed at Mpo and said he will kill two birds with one stone. Denda apologized. Hulisani said he was the one who was supposed to be in jail, not his father. He has fucked up his life and he wants 1 million. Denda said he will give it to him but he must just let go of Mpo. Mpo ran for her life. She bumped into Moipono and Moipono asked her the toilet. Mpo didn't even listen to her and closed the lift. Tenda was about to transfer money and then he found a way to take the gun to Hulisan and punched him so hard, and he was way angry and said he won't be killed by his own child. Thank you so much for watching. Please do not forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you can get more episodes on this channel. 105 Online Channel loves you. Bye, good people.